here today at the Hudson Valley Research Lab looking at a block of Honeycrisp that are on dwarfing rootstock. Any variety of apple can be grafted onto a different rootstock to modify the size of the tree. So these trees will only reach about 10 feet in height. And this allows us to plant them very closely together, and we can have many more trees per acre, in excess of 1,000 trees per acre, thus reducing the carbon footprint and the amount of inputs that we need in order to grow apple. So this variety is a very profitable variety. It's one that's desired by the majority of the public. They know it by name. And so we're here today because these trees have been stressed over the course of a few years by environmental factors such as hurricanes, Hurricane Sandy and Hurricane Katrina, as well as years followed by drought. And during those years where the soil is saturated with water, the trees can't respirate, and so they begin to produce ethanol as a byproduct. And that is a trigger to lure in many different insects such as black stem borer. But these trees also, on this dwarfing rootstock, are infested with dogwood borer. And the dogwood borer will infest the rooting initials, the places where roots want to grow on a rootstock, and the adult female lays its eggs in those rooting initials, and the dogwood borer will essentially feed in and around those areas of the tree where there's not a lot of translocation or movement of nutrients up into the tree. However, during these years of stress, the dogwood borer also experiences stress because of the lack of nutrients and movement of material. And so it'll begin to feed along the outside edge of the tree and begin to girdle the tree, thus sort of suffocating or choking the tree from nutrients. The larva, as I said earlier, infest the trees to a point where they will reduce the vigor of the tree. And you can see how this tree is stunted. And if we look at the base of this tree, you can see that the tree's been compromised because of excessive feeding at the base. And here we find two or three different pupa along the edges, and the pupa are the emergence, an indication of the emergence of the larva from the tree. So this is a fairly recent infestation that's been ongoing for a number of years, and along the edges here you can see that the trunk's been compromised, been fed on, and the tree is no longer supported by the cambium on this side of the tree. There's places where it's still sound, where it's still getting some nutrients, but you could see the tree has just lost its ability to really be productive. There's no fruit on this tree this year. On the adjacent tree, we find the same thing. We find cankering, we find evidence of dogwood borer frass at the base. And so because of lack of management for dogwood borer in this block, we find just real loss of productivity and maybe even death of the tree in years to come.